Some puzzles must be met directly. No puzzle is without an answer.
Thank you. handle this one, Professor. You can't let a puzzle intimidate you.
A challenging puzzle, to be sure. I love the thrill of a good solution.
Thank you.
Some puzzles must be met directly. No puzzle is without an answer. A challenging puzzle, to be sure. A gentleman leaves no puzzle undone.
Thank you.
I think I've got this one. That puzzle was no problem.
Friend.
And who might this be?
Oh, of course. How rude of me.
I'm the professor's assistant, Emmy Altava. It's an honor to meet you, Mr. Triton. I've heard so much about you.
Thank you. Herschel, an assistant. Well, we both seem to have moved up in the world.
Hardly. Truth be told, Emmy has already proven herself my equal.
Herschel, as humble as ever. Emmy, back in London, Leighton and I both wanted to be elite archaeologists. One of us certainly succeeded, and somehow I found myself as mayor of this small, rural town.
That is no small feat, Clark.
Oh, Herschel, no need to humor me. It is amusing at best, I'll give you that. But all that aside, please, tell me, to what do I owe the pleasure of your visit?
I came as soon as I received your letter.
Letter? I'm sorry, Herschel. What letter is that?
The letter that... Did you not send this letter? Please, have a look.
I certainly did not write that, but who would have forged it?
Who indeed? Have you made any enemies recently?
Of course, Herschel. I'm the mayor. It appears to me that someone wanted you here in town.
Yes, that is what I am thinking now as well.
So, who wrote the secret message?
Good question, Emmy.
Mr. Triton, there was a hidden plea for help in that letter.
Clark, do you think this is simply the work of some prankster?
No, unfortunately I don't. Miss Tollery is in grave danger. We have indeed been under attack by some sort of mysterious giant, just as that letter states. It wreaks havoc at night when the fog is thick. It sounds ridiculous, I know. But it is true.
But how can that be?
I must confess I have yet to see this giant with my own eyes. However, the destruction of homes and buildings left in its wake, that is quite enough evidence for me. The townspeople are afraid. They believe that the Spectre has returned with a vengeance.
The Spectre?
There's a legend here that tells of an ancient spirit, a spectre. When the town was in danger, the spectre would act as Miss Tollery's guardian in its moment of need. But this spectre is different. Instead of protecting us, it is trying to destroy us. I am doing all I can, but if we are dealing with an ancient entity, then I fear my efforts are in vain. As the mayor, it is my duty to keep this town and its citizens safe. But I... Herschel, could you...
Sir?
What is it, Doland?
Pardon me, sir,
But you mentioned that Professor Layton worked on some difficult cases for Scotland Yard. You said, with great pride, that he had assisted in solving them all. Perhaps we could ask for his assistance here as well.
Of course, Stoland. I suppose I have no other choice. Herschel, will you help us? Please, for an old friend.
Of course, Clark. I would never refuse a friend in need. I assure you, I will do what I can.
Thank you, Herschel. I am eternally in your debt.
Things are starting to get good, eh, Professor?
Before we go, Clark, I haven't even asked about Brenda, or your son. How is Luke?
My wife is fine. She's away. Family matters. Luke has shut himself up in his room, as usual.
I would like to say hello to Luke, if that is all right. I haven't seen him since he was a baby.
Of course. I think he might enjoy that. I should warn you, he has been withdrawn lately. Some days, I can't even get him out of his room. I ask him what the matter is, and he responds with silence. Perhaps it would be good for him to talk to someone outside of the family. I would appreciate that, Herschel.
My pleasure, Clark. I shall have a few words with Luke before Emmy and I begin our investigation.